Quiet Place is a drama slash horror slash suspense that was co-written, directed, and starring John Krasinski and Emily Blunt. All right, so my initial impression was very good concept and great storytelling. The acting is very good up and down the entire cast. This movie's scary. It's intense right from the get-go. You care about this family. You care about the characters. Just overall, a very good movie experience. All right, so a quick overview, then we'll dive deeper into the movie, and I'm going to keep this as spoilers-free as possible. This is pretty much a survival movie where we follow the Abbott family and their three kids and another one on the way. And now are these monsters that are attracted and hunt by sound. So the trick is to stay as quiet as possible. All right, this movie starts basically 3 months into this event. There's no backstory about how these monsters got here, which I thought was really good. I mean, monsters either come from outer space, or they're genetically engineered, or there's some kind of toxic chemical radiation and things go crazy. This deals nothing with that. This is it. This is what's going on. So the family's already kind of figured some things out and how to survive and how to communicate, which I thought was really good. And it was kind of refreshing. Now, I really like the suspense this concept brings, because everything you do makes noise, you know, so you have to be conscious of everything, every single moment of every single minute. You have to be aware of what noise you're making, because there's really no sense of what's too loud. You know, obviously we all make some kind of noise, but you drop something, that could be it, you know. And then to add even another level to suspense, their daughter's deaf. So not only can't she hear, obviously, but she doesn't really know what kind of sound she's making. So that whole dynamic works really well throughout the film. And that's just like, it's just a constant tension plus the scares that the movie delivers. I think the main reason what makes this movie work so well is the family. It's a family drama. The relationship between John Krasinski and Emily Blunt, obviously they're a couple in real life. That really comes across strong. The family, you know, they're struggling with this new way of life where the consequences are dire. You know, the kids are also kids. They're going to make mistakes. So I thought that was so well done. And I think people are saying, well, you know, is there any talking? It's just a movie about silence. No, this movie speaks volumes. There isn't much dialogue. There's sign language because the daughter is deaf. They can, you know, they'll speak lightly. They seek some solace when they go they collect fish and traps. So the river's really loud, so they can kind of talk there because the overall, you know, the overall sound of the river drowns out anything they would say. But this is definitely quality of dialogue over quantity of dialogue. All right, I'm going to talk Emily Blunt here. Everybody's good, but she, I thought, was excellent. She's pregnant, she's suspecting. So everything is, you know, the contractions, she hurts herself. All that pain she can't scream, she can't yell. Otherwise she's dead and the child's gone. And the emotions that she can convey through, you know, the pain, tears, was just phenomenal. I thought she knocked it out of the park. All right, so let's talk about some of the scares and the monsters. The monsters, I thought, were really well done. They're scary. They're fast. You really can't outrun them. So again, that just adds to the level of tension that if the noise is loud enough, you're pretty much screwed. So I thought that was really well done. There are a few jump scares, like, oh, okay, you know. But hey, they're fun. I think it's something that, you know, the entire audience, you know, there's some laughing after each one. So that's kind of a shared experience. So, yeah, I mean, I could talk about this movie a lot. I may break down certain scenes as more of a spoiler, but I would highly recommend watching A Quiet Place. It's high level movie making. I don't believe this is his first movie. I think John Krasinski directed one or two before, but this is the first movie or film I've seen of his, and he did an outstanding job. So I'm really looking forward to, you know, what he can bring next. One other point about the creatures. I like how he touched on how nature works. You know, sometimes an animal's strongest asset can be its weakest link. It could be the way to defeat it. And I like how that plays into this movie. It was really well done. So, you know, kudos to that. All right, thanks for stopping by Color Positive Movies. Let me know what you thought about A Quiet Place in the comments below. I'm going to throw up another link to some of our other videos. I'd like to check them out. I'm also now on Stardust. It's a really cool app where you kind of do 30-second reviews. Highly recommend you check it out. You just search Color Positive Movies. And we're also looking for subscribers, so our logo, popcorn logo, will come up here at some point. Hit it, and we'd like to have you join us. And until next time.